I'm Ami, and I'm part of the product manager team at Plex. And today I'm going to show you how to use your Shield with a Windows PC to have all your media streaming onto Plex. So before we get started, I want to tell you a bit about me. I work at Plex as a product manager. I love ice cream. And I'm just really trying to solve my problems in my day-to-day. And one of the problems I had was, how do I watch my own content on my TV? And so one of the answers was Plex. And then the other one was a very simple file transfer method, which we're gonna go through today. So let's get started without further ado. The first one is setting up your server. So the first thing you need to have is the NVIDIA Shield. So someone has given it to you, you've bought one, and it's amazing. All you need to do is plug it in, start your TV, and of course, download the Plex app. Once you've downloaded, Plex app will recognize by itself, you don't have to do anything, which is the magic. It will know that there is a Plex media server. So it will tell you, hey, there's a Plex media server. And what you need to do is make sure to enable and tick that enable Plex media server. Then the next part is it will ask if you want default libraries to be created for you. If you click yes, 5 libraries will be created for you in your folders. First one is home videos, then movies, music, TV shows, and pictures. So you will have those 5 if you want to create or not. Of course, you don't need to. It's optional. So now you're ready. You can click next on ready to set up your server. And then it might take a couple of minutes to get it set up, but then it will show you a confirmation and you'll be all ready to go. So now we're getting to the second part, which is the transfer file settings on your Shield. So you're on your Shield and you go into your settings section. And from the settings section, you scroll down and you will see something called general settings. Now within there, you click on device preferences. And then you will see a storage icon and storage marked. You can click on that. Once you get in there, you'll be able to see something that says Shield Storage Access. You want to go into that. And then you will see a toggle, which is about transferring files over your local network. You want to make sure that that toggle is on. And you can also click that. So once the toggle is on, you click on there and you'll be on a page which shows you username, password, and IP address. This 3 information will be important for us when we get into the third part, which is how to access the transfer file options on your Windows PC. So you're on your Windows PC, what you can do is have 2 file explorer open, half the screen, half the screen, for example. On the one half, you have where your videos are that you've taken or you've got from your media. So you can see on my example, I have the one screen part which has my waving video and a video with Enrique waving, which I want to have on my Plex server and watch on my TV. On the other half of the screen, we just have one Windows Explorer, which we'll use to get into the Shield storage. What we're going to do is the File Explorer window that we have to get into the Shield folder, we're going to go at the top and write /// and the IP address that we saw on the Shield. So you just write it down with the numbers and the dots and just click enter. Once you click enter, you might or might not be prompted by a username and password. So if you are prompted by username and password, it's the same one where you saw the IP address on the Shield. Once you add that in and confirm, you will be able to see on that screen what your Shield storage looks like. Now on mine, you'll be able to see there's a Shield storage and also a Toshiba storage. The Toshiba one is for my external hard drive, which I've added, so you might not see that there. But I've changed up my server a bit, and so now it's on the external hard drive. So I'm gonna go into the external hard drive. Now, in the external hard drive, there's different folders. You'll be able to see the NVIDIA Shield folder. Once I click into that, that's where my server is. And you'll be able to see some of the preset libraries, but I've also deleted a couple and also added the test one, which we're using today. So let's get into the test folder. There you can already see I've got my waving video, which exists on my Plex server. So that's exactly mimicking what we see on the Plex server on the TV. Now, what we're gonna do, simply drag and drop Enrique's video from the left side of the screen to the right side. So from my PC folder to my Shield folder, and just wait for it to transfer. Now, you might need to wait a couple of minutes just for it to transfer, or you can also refresh your server, up to you. Before we end the video, let's go over a couple of tips and tricks to make your life easier. So one of the things you can do when you are on your PC is you can pin the folder which you're using for your Plex server. So my test folder, I can go into quick access and pin that so that I can go to it very quickly, easily on my Windows PC. And if you're logged in, you might be able to get into it without putting your username and password again. Another thing you can do is directly download anything onto the test folder. So if you've got any media and you want to stream it and you don't want to download it first to your Windows PC, you can download it directly onto that test folder if I wanted to. So that's something you can do as well, just to make it a little bit easier for you. There you have it. It was really easy, wasn't it? We can now see Enrique waving and the video of it on your TV, and you can just see it on your couch. So we did that together. You can do it too for any of your media to stream on your TV from your NVIDIA Shield and with a Windows PC. So today we went through it all. We went through how to set up your server, how to go into the settings to transfer files on your Shield, how to do the transfer from your PC, and a couple of tips and tricks. Hopefully this was helpful for you. And if you need more information and also manage your server or make it your own, there's all the information you need on the Plex forums as well as the Plex articles. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.